I am on to talk. I know you guys see the title. What's love got to do with it? I'm on my Tina Turner. What's love got to do with it? Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken? All right, enough of that. I hope y'all didn't log off. It's not about me singing. I know I do not know how to sing. The Lord did not bless me with that. I'm still praying on it. It just hasn't manifested yet. But anyway, I know I talked a little about when I did the first video, Love, Faith, and Real Estate, and talked about what Love, Faith, and Real Estate was. I talked a little bit about how learning about how much God loves me transformed my life, right? And it just helped me in so many areas. So, but I have realized, you know, after I did that video, the Lord started showing me things, and I realized there was some areas that I was still challenged in, you know, that the enemy still challenges me in, and, you know, when it comes to God's love, you know, and it's like not feeling like you're enough or you measure up, you know? And so I feel like our job is, when we overcome something, our job as Christians, when we overcome something, is to kick the enemy in his face, basically, and help somebody else, you know, overcome it. So I just wanted to come on and share my story, share, you know, a little bit of encouragement, you know, because I feel like it's so amazing how crazy, for real, how so many people suffer from inferiority or insecurities, you know, don't feel like they're enough. Even the people who you see, like, we may put on everybody, you know, a great facade, but even the people who are cocky and arrogant and, you know, conceited, they may still have inferiority as well. They're just covering it up. They want, you know, other people to think higher of them so that, because they don't, you know, to make up for where they lack at. And so, you know, it's crazy to me. And I just wanted to talk about it. Also, there's people like me who just feel like they have to do more, you know, to be loved or be accepted, you know? And that's just not right. It's not good, you know? So I wanted to come on and talk to you guys about that. And just talk to you about the love of God, because the love of God eradicates all of that. It eradicates every inferiority, every insecurity, every feeling of just not measuring up or not being enough, right? I wanted to tell you, just to talk to you, look you right in your eyes and tell you, you are enough, okay? I believe that when you know God's love for you and you understand it, then it validates you. You know, it makes you, it gives you a sense of comfort, a sense of being enough, right? So even when you were at your lowest state in life, God loved you. He thought you were enough. So Jesus thought you were enough to go and die on the cross for you, to give you the chance to accept him. Not even with a guarantee that you would accept him, but he loved you enough to die on that cross in order to give you a chance to accept him as your Lord and Savior, to give you a chance to be the best you, to give you a chance at a relationship with him, right? And a relationship with your Heavenly Father. So, I mean, that's love at its finest, right? He wants the best of the best for you. All you have to do is believe it and receive it, and it'll change your mind and your life. Now, you heard me say mind first, right? Everything starts with your mind, with your mindset, with the image you have of yourself. Did you know that God made you in his image? He did. He made you and me in his image. When you see yourself loved by the Almighty God, the creator of the universe, he created everything. You know, the trees and the oceans, the lakes, he created all of that, all the animals, but he sees you as his most prized possession. That's something. Like, you are his most prized possession. The Almighty God loves you, and he sees you as his most prized possession, the apple of his eye. You know, and do we see ourselves like that? No. You know, most of us don't. We find all these things wrong with us. We find reasons to put ourselves down, reasons to feel like we're not enough. And why? Why do we do that? The Lord wants to do he wants to do so much for us. He wants to open so many doors for us. He wants to show us favor. He just wants the best of the best for us, like I said, right? Okay, so let's do an exercise. Think about your person. We all have a person, right? Or we're a person to someone else, right? The person that loves you unconditionally, the person that's gonna be there for you no matter what, the person who, you know, you can call when you in a jam, the person who will give you the shirt off their back, the person that just love you to pieces, right? So I know if you're a parent, you're that person to somebody, you're that person to your child, you want the best for them. If you could, if you had the power, you would change everything in their life, you know? So think about that. Think about that person. Imagine what they've done for you. Think about that stuff, right? And then put God in that place, because that's where he is. He loves you more than you could ever imagine, more than you've ever loved anybody, more than anyone's ever loved you. He loves you that much. He wants to bring every dream of yours to pass, right? So we have to let go of those limiting beliefs, right? If the Almighty God wants to do it in us, who are we to stop him? But we do. The problem is we have dominion. We have authority. He has given us dominion and authority, right? And so if we don't believe it, he can't do it. You know, we're limited by the beliefs. He's limited. We handcuff him by our beliefs, by our tongue, by what we allow to come out our mouth, you know, by the inferiority that we feel. Like, we feel like we're not enough to do certain things. I'm not enough to buy a house. I'm not enough. I haven't made it far enough to open that business, or I can't do this, or I can't do that, right? No. I'm here to tell you, you are enough. Look me in my eyes. You are enough, okay? And God loves you, and he wants to do things in your life that you couldn't even imagine. The Bible says he'll do more than you could ever ask or imagine, right? So why don't you receive his love today? Receive it. That's all you got to do is receive it. How, right? Ask him for it. Talk to him. Say, Lord, I want to see your love in a tangible way. Show me how much you love me. Show me who I am in you. Show me, help me to see myself the way you see me, right? Do that. Do it today. I challenge you to do it today. Cultivate that relationship with him. You know, you talk to your friends on the phone all day, or, you know, you talk to different people about your problems, your issues, or even your happy, the things that makes you happy. Talk to him about it. Start talking to him about those things, because he's there and he has the power to, and he wants to bring all your dreams true. So I just wanted to come on and encourage somebody today and know that God loves you and he's there for you, and you are enough. You are enough to do whatever you want to do. So just start thinking big. Start imagining better things. Stop using your imagination to think of the worst case scenario. Start thinking of the best case scenario. Start thinking of yourself like he does. He loves you and he sees you as his most prized possession. All right, so that's all I got for you this week. Remember to subscribe to this video, like it, share it with somebody who needs a little bit of encouragement, a little bit of love on this week. You know, we all have bad days, so, you know, send it to somebody you know. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.